thunder? What's he talking about thunder?
You know, because thunder always comes after lightning. Kapow! Kapow!
Red light, green light. Everybody take a shot. Red light, green light. Give me everything.
You must calibrate the refractometer before every use and between every product. To begin, turn on the refractometer by pressing go. Open the cover and place 3 drops of distilled water over the lens. Close the cover and hit menu twice. Set 0 should appear on the screen. Now wait 20 seconds. After the 20 seconds, hit go and the screen will say ready. Open the lid and wipe lens with a Kim wipe. It is now calibrated. When taking tedious measurements of hot coffee, you must brew a full batch of original coffee. Taking a small cup, fill it 1/4 of the way with fresh hot coffee. Stir the coffee 4 times with a stainless steel spoon. Pipette a sample of the coffee into the 3 individual bowls. Allow each sample to cool for 60 seconds. After cooling, pipette a few drops of the cooled coffee onto the refractometer lens. Make sure there are no air bubbles, as this will give an inaccurate reading. It may be easier to drop the liquid at an angle. Close the lid and wait 20 seconds before pressing any buttons. After the 20 seconds, press go. It should say coffee percent TDS reading. This may take a few seconds, but will give you the TDS measurement. Record each measurement in the refractometer binder. Clean the lens with a Kim wipe and repeat the process for the 2 remaining bowls.
Give me the green light, cause I'm ready to go. Let's have a good time.
Let's go.
What you waiting for? You only got one life.
One life.
And we gon' live it up. So give me the green light.
Next is iced coffee. Taking a small ice cup, fill it 1/4 of the way with iced coffee. Make sure the iced coffee is properly brewed and stirred before taking any measurements. Stir the coffee sample 4 times. Pipette the iced coffee into the 3 sample bowls. Allow to cool for 60 seconds. Taking the pipette, obtain the cooled iced coffee and place over the lens, making sure there are no air bubbles. Close the lid and wait 20 seconds. Press menu until coffee percent TDS appears on screen and then press go twice. Coffee percent TDS reading will appear and may take a few seconds for the TDS measurement to show. Record the measurement in the binder. Repeat the process for the 2 remaining sample bowls. The final TDS measurement is the espresso. First, you need to pull a large shot, medium shot, and a small shot. Discard these shots and then pull your final small shot of espresso. This final shot will be used to measure the TDS. Stir the shot 4 times with a clean stainless steel spoon. Pipette the espresso into the sampling bowl. You don't include the top crema layer as it will give an inaccurate TDS reading. Allow the samples to cool for 60 seconds. Take a pipette of the cooled espresso and place it over the lens, ensuring there are no air bubbles. Close the lens and wait 20 seconds. Press menu until coffee percent TDS appears and press go twice. Repeat this process with the final 2 sample bowls and record the TDS measurements for each bowl. TDS for hot coffee is measured daily. TDS for iced coffee and espresso is done weekly. TDS values for iced coffee range from 1 to 1.2, hot coffee is 0.8 to 1, and espresso is 5.5 to 7. If there are inaccurate readings, follow the guide.
You want to show a video of that though?
No.
I'm thinking.
Ha ba da ba da.